And welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to talk about Treyarch's next Call of Duty game coming in 2024. Because we got some exciting new information from Leaker the Ghost of Hope on Twitter. Now, if you enjoy this video and want to stay connected, consider liking and subscribing. It helps out a lot, and now let's get started. According to Leaker the Ghost of Hope, Treyarch have had their budgets approved for a two-year life cycle on their next installment as part of Activision Blizzard's three-year budget cycle. Activision are hedging their bets on Modern Warfare 2 doing well financially, as well as the infrastructure of COD 2.0. So if you're a Call of Duty fan, this is great. So what this means, Treyarch will have a two-year life cycle, just like Modern Warfare 2. As we all know, Call of Duties have been doing one every year, so they usually drop around October, November more in the past. But so what this means is Call of Duty will be moving more towards a two-year life cycle, at least for these next two games. And for the COD 2.0 side of this tweet, all it is talking about is more of the developer side, meaning that all of these next Call of Duty games are on the same engine. They'll be sharing all the tools and all that stuff compared to previous games. Now, I think it is important to point out why Treyarch deserves 2 years. They have had to fill in for Call of Duty games in the past. They had to bring out Black Ops 4 because Sledgehammer could not get their game done. They had to do Vanguard Zombies because Sledgehammer could not get their game done. Treyarch have to do ranked play, even though it is preferred that they do it. And Modern Warfare 2 seems to not have one yet, or nothing's being talked about it. So you can assume for Infinity Ward, they don't really care about ranked play, so therefore Treyarch has to step in and do it for them as well. So Treyarch deserves this. They have to help out every other studio all the time and never have enough time to finish their games the way they want it to be made. Even in Cold War, they didn't have the full life cycle as they did back in like Black Ops 2. Now, what does this mean for Zombies? This could finally mean Zombie Chronicles 2. As we all know, Zombie Chronicles was the most sold DLC on PlayStation, I believe. Don't think it is anymore, but it was for a period of time, which is huge. If they drop Zombie Chronicles 2 inside of Treyarch's two-year life cycle, that would do great financially for Activision. They could bring back maps like Buried, Nuketown, Mob of the Dead, 5, Call of the Dead. Heck, even bring back Zombie Chronicles. Why not? What this could do for multiplayer, they could bring back more DLC maps, just like Modern Warfare 2 is rumored to have in year 2, with original Modern Warfare 2 maps being DLC. Now, not only does Treyarch deserve this, but it would just be overall good if you're a fan of Call of Duty. They would get more time to fill their game with content compared to their older games having less content at launch because they have to help out all these other studios. And that is all for today. If you enjoy the video and want to stay connected again, consider liking and subscribing. It helps me out a ton. And I will see you in the next one.